Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always. Good morning, everyone. I'm offering this Mass this morning for Maureen Lynch, whose committal I will celebrate later on this afternoon. If you could remember Maureen and her family in your prayers today. Death could not imprison the Lord Jesus. Prison could not chain up the preaching of the good news. Nothing is an obstacle to God, not even ourselves. Like Mary at the empty tomb, we fail to grasp the wonder of your presence. Lord, have mercy. Like the disciples behind closed doors, we are afraid to be seen as your followers. Christ, have mercy. Like Thomas in the upper room, we are slow to believe. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life. Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which, through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we ask, Lord, that what we celebrate in faith, we may possess one day in reality. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The high priest intervened with all his supporters from the party of the Sadducees. Prompted by jealousy, they arrested the apostles and had them put in the common jail. At night, the angel of the Lord opened the prison gates and said, as he led out the apostles, "Go and stand in the temple and tell the people all about this new life." They did as they were told. They went into the temple at dawn and began to preach. When the high priest arrived, he and his supporters convened the Sanhedrin. This was the full Senate of Israel, and sent to the jail for the apostles to be brought to them. But when the officials arrived at the prison, they found that they were not inside. So they went back and reported, "We found the jail securely locked and the warders on duty at the gates. But when we unlocked the doors, we found no one inside." When the captain of the temple and the chief priests heard this news, they wondered what it could mean. Then a man arrived with fresh news. "At this very moment," he said, "the men you imprisoned are in the temple. They are standing there preaching to the people." The captain went with his men and fetched them. They were afraid to use force in case the people stoned them. The word of the Lord. This poor man called, and the Lord helped him. I will bless the Lord at all times, his praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast, the humble shall hear and be glad. Glorify the Lord with me, Together let us praise his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me. From all my terrors he set me free. Look towards him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him, and rescued him from all his distress. The angel of the Lord is encamped around those who revere him, to rescue him. Taste and see that the Lord is good. He is happy who seeks refuge in him. Gospel of the Lord. This is the third warning that we have heard of Jesus challenging Nicodemus. Nicodemus saw his religion as his way of pleasing God. He was a good, observant Jew, faithful to the law. No doubt he hoped that God would be pleased with him. But here we find Jesus saying, God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son. Jesus turns things on their head. Instead of humanity using religion to turn to God and to please him, here is God using religion to turn to humanity and please us. God is no longer in his heaven and all is right with the world. God is now in his world and all is right with his heaven. Nicodemus is being challenged on his idea of who God is, of what God wants of him, of how God relates to his creation, of how Nicodemus should respond. As we don't hear of Nicodemus again until after the crucifixion, presumably he has went off and considered these things and come round to Jesus' way of thinking. A big conversion for a religious man. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it our own by a worthy way of living. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this Easter season above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Easter joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as together we acclaim, Holy, Holy, and clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus taught, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait in joyful hope the return of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, after your resurrection, you appealed to your disciples with the greeting, "Peace be with you." Look not on our sins, but on our faith, and grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world. Grant us your peace. Grant us your peace. Grant us your peace, O Lord.
Behold the risen Lord, who comes to us under the appearance of bread and wine. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Risen Lord, I believe that you are now present in this most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire that you fill my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, fill my heart. Unite us as one. Never let me be parted from you. Amen. present to your people, Lord, and lead those who have celebrated these heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to the fullness of new life. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Mass tomorrow will be at 10 a.m. Have a safe and a good day. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in the peace of God.